Shifts in consumer behaviour, forecasted trends and increased investment activity suggest that digital disruption is reaching critical mass in North American food retailing. This then is how to win the digital revolution. Grocery e-commerce is an important part of the shopping experience in Asia Pacific and Europe, but North American grocery sellers have lagged behind until now. Amazon Fresh is blooming, Walmart has expanded its online food sales into Canada, Click and Collect is growing thanks to services like Fresh Direct, Peapod, and retailers like ShopRite, and the millennials, well, they want more.
I would say the demographics are the biggest change, right? The expectation of the consumer now, as we all know, is internet first for information, internet first for purchase. So, it's one of those things that as we talk to our client base and others, that if you're not in the consideration set, you are completely left out of the option for the consumer to buy. So that has been huge. And of course, mobile, that instant access.
Rich Tarrant is CEO for MyWebGrocer, which has been helping food retailers go digital since 1999. What questions does he see retail and CPG management teams grappling with in the face of these changes?
Starting with the retailer, I think one of the big things that they ask is, in a very complicated business that is low margin, how do we offer a sort of an omni-channel experience and try and maintain margins, right? We hear a lot about the economics in the grocery space. We hear a lot about the economics on the last mile for e-commerce. How do I resolve all of those things? How do I get into the space economically? And how do I satisfy my customers to embed the loyalty to me and not to someone else? So they're grappling with all of those things. Completely understandable. It's, retail grocery is a difficult business. CPGs, on the other hand, the traditional mechanisms for influencing the purchase or driving volume are all being disrupted. As I like to say, end caps are great unless the consumer is not in the store. Then it doesn't affect that consumer. So how do we take these vehicles that we relied on for so long and shift them to engage the customers how they want them, where they want them, and with the right information, not just sort of a blanket information? So all of those things are being wrestled with on both sides of the grocery trade.
So what should grocers do first? How should they start to answer these questions and create a strategy that really helps them respond?
Clearly, engaging digitally with the consumer is paramount. We like to say that the weekly flyer that goes into a newspaper is great, but newspaper distribution is way down. Well, how do you migrate that into the digital space so that you can get the right information to the consumer to inspire them to buy at your store? And that is a big transition. Building a foundation, a digital foundation, a digital communication set is a big deal. And then pivoting from there and growing your online channel, to us, we think is paramount. The best thing you can do is find partners to partner with. We're an internet company and we have lots of partners. If you look at sort of the disruptive technologies, to reinvent a wheel that someone else has figured out doesn't make a whole lot of sense in this space, because next year there's going to be a new wheel, right? 8 years ago, who would have thought mobile would be as dominant as it is? Social networks, 4 or 5 years ago. What's going to be next year? So, just as we do in our business, and we're a digital company, we advise our clients in the conversations that we're having, and say, look, find partners that can help you drive your business with the goal of sort of moving volume, and partner up with them. That's the fastest way to stay nimble in this space. How can you not offer mobile commerce nowadays, right? Making sure that you're engaged with the consumer on the levels that they want to engage with you is paramount. You can't be operating under the expectation any longer that the 26-year-old is going to be grabbing the local newspaper and flipping through the pages. They're not. They're grabbing their iPad and they're getting the news feeds that they're interested in. So it's shifted.
Ah, good old digital disruption. And what impact has this seismic shift had on the relationship between grocers and CPGs?
The nice thing about our space is CPG companies and grocers have a long history of collaborating to drive each other's end goals, right? At the end of the day, the retail grocer wants the product sold out of their stores and the brand wants it to be their product that moves. So how do you engage a consumer in the digital space using social, using mobile, on a local level? I mean, you got to remember, retail grocers are as local as it gets. What a huge advantage. Leverage that so that the consumer is engaged and inspired to buy the product from that retail outlet. And the CPGs are inspired to do this because at the end of the day, they need to get their product on the digital shopping list. Because if it's there, you embed the loyalty. The other thing that is very powerful in how they can cooperate is that digital allows for very rich data assets. So no longer do we have to sort of blanket and carpet bomb offers. We can actually target on a personal level the right information to this instant gratification consumer. Which is really important to do for both constituencies. So we're seeing a lot of good cooperation between the two groups, and we think that will only increase.
Of course, Rich is right. CPGs and retailers have a long history of partnering together to drive volume, but what of the future? What should be their first practical steps on this new journey?
Build a foundational sort of digital engagement place. Doesn't mean that they have to offer every SKU in online shopping everywhere at this moment. But they need to have the basic communication channels open to engage with the customers, okay? And there's plenty that haven't done that yet. The other thing they need to do is start leveraging data more effectively. There's a real rich footprint of data in the digital space that allows you to target the right consumers with the right message and the right information. Why not use that to make your spend that much more effective? The other beautiful thing about digital is it's really easy to determine ROI. So, you know, when you find something that works, great, then keep on driving that. Getting the digital foundation is paramount. You know, if you're going to drive digital connectivity, then you have to have the tools available to the consumer so that they can engage with you. You know, consumers are spending an inordinate amount of time on their mobile devices. Do you have mobile commerce? Well, if you don't have mobile commerce, then you're missing a big opportunity. Do you have ways to engage with them on the mobile device, right, to message them appropriately and relevantly, right? The idea of digital and the way consumers are consuming digital now is that personalization is a very big deal. How do you leverage data and how do you target consumers with the right message, which, by the way, is way more economical for both the retailer and the CPG. So they should want to get there, and they do. And that is where the space is headed. I mean, MyWebGrocer is in effect the digital webbing between the retailers and the CPGs, right? We assist both of them in collaborating to execute these digital strategies. And if there's something that we can't do for them, we engage partners to make sure we execute to ensure that it drives the goal of the CPG brand or the retail brand. You know, at the end of the day, our goal is to help both sides get more engaged digitally to drive success and drive volume through the digital channel at the retail outlet and for the CPG brand.